Good morning, students. Today I am here again with a new chapter, that is chapter 10, the light. This is part 1 of chapter 10, and in this part 1 we will learn about two topics only. What are these two topics? Let me show you. The first one is reflection of light, and the second one is spherical mirrors. So in this part 1 we will learn only these two points one by one. So let me start here with. See, in your surroundings, when you notice the variety of objects are there and you are able to see them. But in the dark room, if you try to see the things, you are not able to see the things. They are not visible. When you light up the room, the things are visible. So what makes them visible? During the light, during the daytime, they are visible, but in a dark room, they are not visible. So what makes the things visible and how we are able to see the things? See, during the daytime, sunlight is there. And that sunlight helps us to see the objects. And how does it help us? It helps us in the way that when sunlight falls on any object, the object reflects the light and that reflected light falls on our eyes and we are able to see the things. Very simple. In the dark room, when there is no light, the light will not fall on any object and the object will not reflect the light to our eyes. So we will not be able to see the things. So that is the simple reason why we are able to see the things in light yet during daytime and why we are not able to see the things in dark room. Okay. So related to the light, there are very common and wonderful phenomena in this world that we can learn, we can explore by studying the light. And they are image formation by mirrors that we are going to study in this chapter. Twinkling of stars that we will learn when we will learn about refraction, beautiful colors of rainbow, bending of light by a medium, that is again the example of refraction of light. So all these things we will study when we will study about reflection and refraction of light. Okay. See, by observing the common optical phenomena around us, we may conclude the light seems to travel in straight line. The fact that a small source of light casts a sharp shadow of an opaque object points to this straight line path of the light. And this straight line path of the light is known as ray of the light. That can be seen with the help of this simple activity. This simple activity you must have done in your smaller classes, that with the help of three cardboards, cardboard A, cardboard B and cardboard C. These three are the cardboards and that is a burning candle. Three holes are made in these cardboards at the same height. Height of hole A and height of hole B and height of hole C is equal. So you can see the light is traveling through these holes. But the moment you change the height of any of the cardboard out of all these three cardboards, you are not able to see the path of the light. It means the light travels in a straight line or straight path. And that path is known as the ray of the light. Okay. Reflection of light. This is the first topic in this chapter we will learn. A highly polished surface such as mirror reflects most of the light falling off it. And you are already familiar with the laws of reflection of light. In your smaller standard, you must have learned these laws. But then also today I am having these two laws of reflection. And I'll explain both the laws one by one. The first one is the angle of incidence is equal to the angle of reflection. And the second is the incident ray, the normal to the mirror at the point of incidence and the reflected ray. These three lie in the same plane. These are two laws of reflection. I can explain you with the help of the diagram. This is the diagram of reflection. This is plane mirror and that side is polished and that is the reflecting surface. This is normal to the mirror, that is incident ray, that is reflected ray, that is angle of incidence, that is angle of reflection. And the first law, what does it say? It says that angle of incidence is equal to the angle of reflection. Theta I is equal to theta R. This is the first law of reflection. Now move to the second law of reflection. What does it say? Let me read it again for you. It says that incident ray, the normal and the reflected ray, incident ray, the normal and the reflected ray, they lie in the same plane. These are the laws of reflection. And these laws of reflection are applicable to each and every mirror, whether it is plane or it is spherical. When we are talking about the plane mirror, what are the properties of the image? You have learned the image formation by a plane mirror. The properties of image are that the image formed by a plane mirror is always and always virtual and erect. The size of the image is always equal to the object. An image is formed behind the mirror, and the distance between the mirror and the object is always equal to the distance between the distance between image and the mirror. Okay, and the very important property of the image formed by plane mirror is the image is laterally inverted. Now let me explain you all these properties by drawing a diagram over here. The diagram may not be that much good, but please bear with me. I think we can explain the image formation by a plane mirror with this diagram. This you can see that is a plane mirror. A and B. This is a plane mirror. Okay. And that is the object in front of the plane mirror. Now, image will be formed over here. Okay, see, you can see the height of the image is equal to the height of the object. The second thing, it is behind the mirror. It is erect, matlab seedha hai ekdam. It is virtual. Virtual means actually rays of the light are not meeting at this point. They are appear to meet at this point. That is why the image is virtual. Very important thing is this image is laterally inverted. What is lateral inversion? That lateral inversion, even you can also notice when you are standing in front of a mirror and you raise your left hand, what do you observe in the mirror with your image? You observe that your image is raising its right hand. That is lateral inversion. Okay, so this was the image formation by a plane mirror. What happens when the surface is curved? It is not plain. In your kitchen, you are having spoons, and with the curved surface of the spoon, you can form the images. The most commonly used type of curved mirror is the spherical mirror. The reflecting surface of such mirrors can be considered to form a part of the surface of a sphere. Such mirrors whose reflecting surfaces are spherical are called spherical mirrors. This is the definition of spherical mirrors. Now we will study about the spherical mirrors in detail. This is activity 10.1 that I have taken from your textbook. It is given at page number 161. It says that take a large shining spoon and try to view your face in its curved surface. Do you get the image? The image is smaller or it is larger? What do you notice? Now do one thing, move the spoon slowly away from your face and now observe the image. Is it changed or is it same? Do this activity, repeat this activity and note down your observation. What do you see? Actually, it is a very funny activity. Everybody has done it. Even if it is not in your textbook, then also we do it. Take a new spoon if you are having it at your, I'm sure that you are having it in your kitchen. Ask your mother to give it to you. And then try to see your face in this spoon. What do you observe? If you are facing the spoon in this form, the curved surface is in front of your face. At that time, the image formation will be of different time. But if you change the curved surface of the spoon, the image formation will also be changed. The property of the image will be changed. So after completing this session, you do this activity and note down the observation. What do you observe? whether the image will be erect, whether it will be inverted, whether it will be smaller or it will be enlarged. Okay. Spherical mirror. The reflecting surface of spherical mirror may be curved inward or outward. या तो curved surface अंदर की तरफ होगा या curved surface बाहर की तरफ होगा. अगर curved surface अंदर की तरफ है तो ऐसे मिरर को हम बोलते हैं कॉनकेव मिरर, और अगर कर्व सरफेस बाहर की तरफ है तो ऐसे मिरर को हम बोलते हैं कॉन्वेक्स मिरर. इट इज इजी टू आइडेंटिफाई. नाउ लेट मी डिफाइन बोथ द स्फेरिकल मिरर्स वन बाय वन. अ स्फेरिकल मिरर हुज रिफ्लेक्टिंग सरफेस इज कर्व्ड इनवर्ड्स इज नोन एज कॉनकेव मिरर, एंड द स्फेरिकल मिरर हुज रिफ्लेक्टिंग सरफेस इज कर्व्ड आउटवर्ड is known as convex mirror. That is the definition of concave mirror and convex mirror. You may now understand the surface of the spoon curved inward can be approximated to a concave mirror, and the surface of the spoon bulged outward can be approximated to a convex mirror. See, when we are learning about spherical mirrors, there are some terms that we will be using frequently. So you should know those terms, you should know the definitions of those terms before you start learning image formation by spherical mirror. So one by one I will explain those terms, I will define those terms to you. The first one is pole. This is the center of reflecting surface of a spherical mirror is a point, and that is known as pole. Here you can see it. Follow my red pen. That is the spherical mirror, and the center of this mirror over here, this is a point, and this point is known as pole. It is denoted by P, and this point is on the surface of the mirror. Ye point mirror ki surface par hi hota hai. Okay, now center of curvature. Okay, the reflecting surface of a spherical mirror forms a part of the sphere. Very important point. इस पर जरा ध्यान दो कि कोई भी reflecting surface होती है, ये जो mirror है हमारा, ये किसी sphere का part होती है. ये जो आपका reflecting surface है, किसका part है? इस sphere का. Okay? और जब ये sphere है, तो इसका कोई center भी होगा. और उसी center को हम center of curvature बोलते हैं. Very easy to define. The center of the sphere of which the reflecting surface is a part is known as center of curvature. Okay, the C is center of curvature. This is the center of concave mirror, and this is the center of convex mirror. The center of curvature is not a part of the mirror. Very important point. What did we do right now when we were learning about pole? Pole kya tha? Pole was a part of spherical mirror. वो center में था, but center of curvature is not a part of the mirror. ये mirror से बाहर होता है. देखो, ये आपका mirror है यहाँ पर, और center of curvature यहाँ पर है. तो ये mirror का part नहीं है. Important point है, one mark में MCQ भी आता है कि which one is not a part of center, part of mirror. तो आप आराम से लिख सकते हैं कि center of curvature is not the part of the mirror. It lies outside its reflecting surface. अगर concave mirror है तो उसका center of curvature उसके सामने होता है यहाँ पर, और अगर convex mirror है तो उसका center of curvature उसके पीछे होता है. Okay? The next point is radius of curvature. That is also again a very simple term कि ये जो हमारा spherical mirror है, ये किसी sphere का part है. तो उस स्फेयर की रेडियस को हम बोलते हैं रेडियस ऑफ कर्वेचर. द रेडियस ऑफ द स्फेयर ऑफ विच द रिफ्लेक्टिंग सरफेस इज अ पार्ट इज नोन एज रेडियस ऑफ कर्वेचर. हियर यू कैन सी दिस इज रेडियस ऑफ कर्वेचर, एंड इट इज रिप्रेजेंटेड बाय आर. इन डायग्राम यू कैन सी आर मीन्स दिस पी सी, पी टू सी, दिस डिस्टेंस इज कॉल्ड रेडियस ऑफ कर्वेचर. Okay, now we come to principal axis. Principal axis is the imaginary straight line that is passing through the pole and center of curvature. This one, this is principal axis, okay, that is imaginary line. And remember, the principal axis is the normal to the mirror at its pole. Agar pole par koi normal dala jaye, so that will be principal axis. Ab how to explain this? Let me come over here to the lens. This is the lens. ये एक लेंस है, इधर रेड पेन को फॉलो करिए, और इस लेंस का ये पोल होगा, सेंटर में होता है ना पोल, दिस वन इज पोल. तो ये पोल पर जो 90 डिग्री हम डालेंगे, दैट इज प्रिंसिपल एक्सिस. ओके, दिस इज एक्टिविटी 10.2 अगेन दैट आई हैव टेकन फ्रॉम योर बुक. इट इज गिवन एट पेज नंबर 162. व्हाट डज इट से? इट सेज दैट डू नॉट लुक एट द सन डायरेक्टली और इवन इनटू अ मिरर रिफ्लेक्टिंग सनलाइट. Why? Because it can damage your eyes. Hold a concave mirror in your hand and direct its reflecting surface toward the sun. Now, direct the light reflected by the mirror to a sheet. And that sheet is to be held very close to the mirror. So, can all the light reflected by the mirror can fall on the sheet. Move the sheet of the paper back and forth gradually until you find on the paper sheet a bright, sharp spot of light. What is that bright sharp spot of light? This is the image of the sun that is formed on the paper. Now hold the mirror and the paper in the same position for a few minutes. What do you observe and why do you observe that? You observe that the paper starts burning. Why does it happen? The paper, at first the paper start burning and that will produce smoke. But eventually it may even catch fire also. Aag lag jayegi paper mein. Why does it burn? Because the light from the sun is converged at a point as a sharp bright spot. And how does it happen? It happens due to the reflection of sunlight by the mirror. Pura light focus hoke paper pe aata hai aur paper jalna shuru ho jata hai. In fact, this spot of light is image of the sun, as I told you, on the sheet of the paper. And this point is the focus of the concave mirror. The heat produced due to the concentration of sunlight ignites the paper, and the distance of the image from the position of the mirror gives the approximate value of focal length of the mirror. Yahan hamara concern kya hai? Hamara concern hai focus aur focal length janna. Matlab jo sunlight rays, jo rays mirror pe padti hain, they are parallel. Kyun? Kyunki bahut distance se aa rahi hain. रिफ्लेक्शन के बाद वो सारी की सारी एक पॉइंट पर इकट्ठी होती हैं या वहां से वो क्रॉस करती हैं. दैट पॉइंट इज नोन एज फोकस. और लेंस से वो डिस्टेंस फोकस का इज नोन एज फोकल लेंथ. तो ये दोनों पॉइंट हमको याद रखने. वन बाय वन यहाँ पर अब मैं एक्सप्लेन करूंगी. प्रिंसिपल फोकस जो अभी हम बात कर रहे थे, प्रिंसिपल फोकस जानने के लिए ही वो एक्टिविटी की गई थी. प्रिंसिपल फोकस क्या है? सी, ये आपका मिरर है. And this is the object. And you can see that rays are falling on the mirror from this object. This one, this one, this one. Okay. After the reflection, these rays are passing through a point, and that point is known as focus. Mirror ki principal axis ke parallel aane wali rays after reflections jahan se pass hoti hain, उस पॉइंट को हम बोलते हैं फोकस. ओके, एंड पोल से फोकस की डिस्टेंस को हम बोलते हैं फोकल लेंथ. सो दीज वर टू इंपॉर्टेंट डेफिनेशंस अबाउट रिफ्लेक्टिंग मिरर. व्हेन यू आर लर्निंग अबाउट रिफ्लेक्टिंग मिरर, यू नीड टू नो अबाउट फोकस और फोकल लेंथ. ओके, principle of focus of the concave mirror. Okay, now let me read it out for you. A number of rays parallel to the principal axis are falling on a concave mirror. They all are meeting at a point on the principal axis, and that point is known as principal focus of the concave mirror. In the same manner, it can be defined for convex mirror. The parallel rays to the principal axis, after reflection, they appear to come from a point on the principal axis, एंड दिस पॉइंट इज नोन एज प्रिंसिपल फोकस ऑफ द कॉन्वेक्स मिरर. कॉनकेव मिरर में एक्चुअली दे आर मीटिंग एट दिस पॉइंट, बट कॉनकेव मिरर में दे आर नॉट एक्चुअली मीटिंग, बट दे आर अपीयर, हमको ऐसा लगता है दे अपीयर टू कम फ्रॉम द पॉइंट, दिस पॉइंट, एक ही पॉइंट से सारी रेज आ रही हैं. तो यहाँ पर ये फोकस पॉइंट है. द डिस्टेंस बिटवीन द पोल एंड द प्रिंसिपल फोकस ऑफ द स्फेरिकल मिरर इज नोन एज द फोकल लेंथ. यहाँ पर फोकल लेंथ क्या है, पी एफ इज फोकल लेंथ, एंड हियर पी एफ इज द फोकल लेंथ, ओके, एंड दैट इज रिप्रेजेंटेड बाय अ लेटर एफ, और फोकस को हम बोलते हैं कैपिटल एफ. एपरेचर, व्हाट इज एपरेचर, सी द रिफ्लेक्टिंग सरफेस ऑफ ए स्फेरिकल मिरर इज बाय एंड लार्ज स्फेरिकल, यहां से दिस इज स्फेरिकल, ओके, दिस माय दैट पेन एम एम डैश, दैट इज द मिरर, ओके, एंड दिस सरफेस हैज अ सर्कुलर आउटलाइन, दैट आउटलाइन आई एम डूइंग विद माय दैट पेन. द डायमीटर ऑफ द रिफ्लेक्टिंग सरफेस ऑफ ए स्फेरिकल मिरर इज कॉल्ड एपरेचर, दिस इज द डायमीटर ऑफ दिस स्फेरिकल मिरर. सी हियर आई एम नॉट टॉकिंग अबाउट द स्फीयर, हियर आई एम टॉकिंग अबाउट ओनली दिस स्फेरिकल मिरर, दिस वन, ओके. डिस्टेंस एम एन, इसको एम डैश की जगह इसको एन कर लीजिए, डिस्टेंस एम एन रिप्रेजेंट्स द एपरेचर. We shall consider in our discussion only such spherical mirrors whose aperture is much smaller than its radius of curvature. Is there a relationship between the radius of curvature and focal length of a spherical mirror? Yes, there is a relationship. There is a formula. R is equal to 2f. The radius of curvature is double of focal length. Okay, here this is the animation. This animation gives you an idea about the points of spherical mirrors. One by one I will be explaining all this. Definition I will not explain, I'll just tell you the points. See, this is spherical mirror, okay, and this is principal axis. यहाँ देखो P से जो लाइन जा रही है, P और C से, दैट इज प्रिंसिपल एक्सिस, ओके. दिस पॉइंट इज फोकस, दिस पॉइंट इज सेंटर ऑफ कर्वेचर. लेंथ बिटवीन P एंड F इज नोन एज फोकल लेंथ, एंड ओके, एंड दिस लेंथ इज रेडियस ऑफ कर्वेचर. So these are the terms related to spherical mirror. These are very important terms. And whenever we are learning about these spherical mirrors, we need to know them first, then only we can study. Now your today's work is, whatever definitions we learn today, one by one you write them, draw a diagram and show these points on that diagram. The diagram may be of concave mirror or convex mirror, no problem. So what you are supposed to write today, the pole, the focus, focal length, center of curvature, radius of curvature, principal axis and aperture. These all are very important definitions about spherical mirrors. And now wait for part 2. Tomorrow I'll come with part 2 of this chapter. Thank you, students.